वेलकम बैक फ्रेंड्स, आई एम राजदीप आचार्य बैक अगेन विथ अनदर न्यू लेक्चर एंड इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू टॉकिंग अबाउट आइसो इलेक्ट्रिक फोकसिंग एंड दिस लेक्चर इज गोइंग टू बी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर CSIR नेट ऑल्सो गाइस, सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। सो व्हाट इज एक्चुअली आइसो इलेक्ट्रिक फोकसिंग? सो बेसिकली आइसो इलेक्ट्रिक फोकसिंग इज एक्चुअली वन काइंड ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोफोरेसिस टेक्निक व्हिच एक्चुअली सेपरेट प्रोटीन मॉलिक्यूल on the basis of their PI value. So what is actually PI value? PI value is actually the isoelectric point. So basically PI value is actually the isoelectric point, and each and every protein has their own particular isoelectric point. So basically the isoelectric focusing is actually one kind of electrophoresis technique which actually used to separate protein molecule of same molecular weight, but in this case the protein molecule used to separate by the basis of PI value, I mean the isoelectric point. So basically the discoverer of isoelectric focusing is actually H. Svensson. So what is actually PI value? So this is the question in all of your mind, that the protein molecules are separating from each other on the basis of PI value. So PI value is actually the isoelectric point which is actually equal to the isoelectric pH of this medium. So basically when a protein sample reach at their PI value, in their PI, I mean the isoelectric point, this protein sample will form Zwitter ion, and that time the protein sample will stop migrating and they will stop at that moment and they will carry zero charge. So this is actually the isoelectric point. That means the isoelectric point is actually equal to isoelectric pH of medium, and in isoelectric point the net charge of sample protein will be zero and the protein sample will stop migration and the sample protein forms Zwitter ion. And the discoverer of isoelectric focusing is actually H. Svensson. So let's move to the next. So why should we have to use isoelectric focusing electrophoresis technique instead of having SDS page electrophoresis? The need of isoelectric focusing is that suppose protein A molecule has 5 molecular weight, protein B molecule also has the same 5 molecular weight. When you guys will put the protein A and protein B sample in the gel block of SDS page, and you guys will run the current from anode to cathode, they will form a single band in the 5 molecular weight. So protein A and protein B will form a single band at 5 molecular weight, because we know that SDS page separate protein molecule on the basis of molecular weight. So basically as protein A and protein B both has the same molecular weight, so basically they will stop migration at 5 molecular weight. So they will form a single band. That time you guys will have problem to distinguish protein A and protein B from a single sharp stationary band. So to overcome this problem we have to use isoelectric focusing, because each and every protein has their particular isoelectric point. That means if a protein has the same molecular weight, those proteins also have isoelectric point, but in this case the isoelectric point will be different. That is actually the PI value. So what is actually isoelectric focusing? The definition is actually, it is actually electrophoresis technique on polyacrylamide gel block with lengthwise maintained pH gradient and voltage gradient so that the migrant component stop migrating and settle into a separate immobile or stationary phase band on reaching the zone of its isoelectric pH. And this is actually the procedure. So the first point of this procedure is that the electrophoresis is the electrophoresis is carried out in a vertical column or a horizontal slab of cross-linked polyacrylamide gel. So this is actually a horizontal vertical column. So you guys can see that this is actually the sample that is prepared. I mean, it is actually the polyacrylamide gel block that is actually prepared with well-maintained pH gradient, and it is actually the sample protein that is actually injected in this gel block. And after a particular time, you guys can see separate band at the separate place. So this is actually the protein is actually injected. All those proteins are actually injected in a particular place, but after a certain time they migrate toward their isoelectric point, and that's why those bands are formed. And this is how the proteins are actually getting separated from each other. So you guys can see that stable gel pH gradient is maintained by carrier ampholytes. Microgram amount of sample is applied on gel block. The ionized component will migrate toward the electrode with opposite polarity, but because of gel pH gradient, each migrant compound loses its charge as well as its rate of migration. Finally, on reaching the zone of its isoelectric pH on gel block, it forms Zwitter ion, which further stop electrophoretic migration. And after that, all the sample component will form separate sharp stationary band at the site of their respective isoelectric pH on the gel block. Now gel block are stained and studied by UV absorbency, UV fluorometry, scintillation spectrometry. So suppose guys, it is actually an example. Suppose guys, it is protein A, it is protein B, and protein A and protein B both are having same 5 and 5 molecular weight, but they are having different PI value, I mean isoelectric point. So suppose it is actually a strip, and in this strip, it is IgE strip, you guys can see that protein A is red. So this is actually protein red, I mean it is actually red protein A. It is actually protein B is blue, so this is actually blue color, this is actually protein B. So suppose in this strip I injected the protein A here and protein B here, but the protein A is having 3 PI value. So when I will inject this protein A here, this protein will migrate toward 3 PI value. And in case of protein B, the protein B is having PI value 8. So the protein B, after a particular time, it will move from 7 to 8. So this is how actually those proteins are having same molecular weight, but they are actually separating from each other on the basis of PI value.